What's up everyone, it's your boy Kids Coding, and today we're back with some more HTML. Many of you are sitting at home vibing and enjoying my HTML content, so might as well do some more HTML videos. Today's video will combine two of my favorite things, HTML and YouTube. I'm simply going to teach you how to play a YouTube video on your HTML webpage, along with how we can control that. Keep in mind that I will not demonstrate any of this because unfortunately, my videos do not work with this chapter, so I'm going to have to use other people's videos, and then that will cause a YouTube problem, and yeah, so I'm not going to demonstrate it, but I think I'll explain it in a way that y'all can understand. Before we go over that, I just need to go over through the video types. So there are simply three video types. There's a .webm, a .mp4, and a .ogg. I recommend making your default browser as Chrome. I don't know how you can do it on Mac, but on Windows you can just simply do settings, and then once you go to your settings you can do default apps, and then once you do that you scroll all the way down and make it Chrome. I say this because Chrome accepts all three files. And yeah, a lot of other browsers, they don't accept all three files, and then that will cause a problem, and then all that stuff. But yeah, if you know how to do it on Mac, put it in the comments below. I don't know how to do it on Mac, never used a Mac. Anyway, let's get started with how we can input a simple YouTube video. Really, what we need to do in order to make a simple YouTube video is we need to do something called iframes. I did a video on iframes, like when I started early middle school, sixth grade. And yeah, it's somewhere in my HTML playlist. It's on the top right hand corner. You can search for it, click on it, watch it. Many iframes won't show up because that's just how iframes are. Probably one of the most annoying topics in HTML. So yeah, I had to pick a video where I could, you know what I mean. Not a lot of iframes properly work, so I'm gonna have to use a third party website. So yeah, and that's the reason why I won't demonstrate it. So to simply start, we do the iframe tag, which is iframe. After that, we need to set a specific height and width of the video. So I'm gonna do, what's a good one? I'm gonna do 380 height and then a 420 width. And then after that, you will then need to do a source equal, and then in quotation marks, you paste the link of the video. It can be any YouTube video, but not a lot of them will work. I wanted to do my own videos, but they don't work. So you're going to have to find a link that works. If you can't find one, you can use my link. I'll probably put it in the comments below so that you can copy and paste it. But yeah, on that, we can just then close it from here and then do an iframe. And I think from there, we're good to go. So let's go here, go to our files, and then let's open it up. Let's open it up. And the video should load. And there, it loads. So yeah, that's just simply how we can put a video. Now I'm going to talk about all the elements that you can put in a video. These are extensions. They're all extensions. So it's like, they're like what you put after the link. So, in order to do that, I'm going to first talk about, the first thing, which is autoplay. Autoplay will simply, just play the video when you make the changes. So in order to do the autoplay, you need to apply a specific extension which comes after the link. So what this simply is that it's a question mark and then it's autoplay and then equal one, like that. That is the extension. It will be shown on the screen, but yeah, that's the extension. Question mark, autoplay, equal one. And yeah, just do that after the video URL. And this means that the video will play automatically. I don't want to show it because of YouTube's guidelines. But anyway, yeah, that is pretty much that. So like when you reload it, just quickly, yeah, I just paused it. But yeah, that's what happens. Zero pretty much nullifies it, cancels it. So then if you save it, it won't autoplay, nothing happens. It won't autoplay. That's what happens when you put a zero. So that is pretty much how the autoplay works. Once you do it, then it will simply play. Next, we have something called the loop. This one's a little bit more complicated, so I'm gonna show it on the screen. And keep in mind that we're doing this after the extension. So in order to do a loop, we need to do, first we need to do playlist. It doesn't have to be a playlist. In this case, I'm doing one specific video. So yeah, it's playlist. After this, we need an equal sign. And then here, from here, we need the ending of the link. So right here is the ending of the link. So we need to copy that and then paste it again. And then once we do that, then we need the at symbol. And then we're going to do loop. And then we're going to make it equal 1. And I think from there we're good to go. I'm going to put the extension on the screen so you can copy from it. I'm going to do it based on my video. You can change the TGB, whatever. That varies based on the video. It's the ending of the link. So that is pretty much that. Reload it. So whenever the video finishes, then it's going to start back again. You won't have to do anything. That's what the loop does. And once again, I will not demonstrate it. So lastly, we have something called the controls. And what this controls does is that, like when you watch a YouTube video, they have like those bottom controls that you can like pause, volume, all that kind of stuff, fast forward. Yeah. So what the controls does is that it will pretty much hide that. It will block it and you cannot like do anything to it. The extension is just similar to the autoplay. It's not a lot wacky like the loop. It's just question mark, controls, and then equal 0. And by the way, I don't think I covered it, but in the loop, let me show you again. So if I made the loop 0, then nothing will happen. So the loop will be omitted and it won't loop. I just wanted to cover that because, why not? I just simply wanted to cover that because, I didn't cover it. So it's a lot similar to the autoplay. So from there, we did it. That's the extension. The extension will show on the screen. So it's just simply question mark controls equals 0. And that is the extension of the original page. And what this will do is that since it's a zero, zeros usually omit things. So it's going to hide the bottom controls that you see on a YouTube video. I'm going to put an image right on the screen to show you how the controls look like because I can't demonstrate it. But yeah, it'll pretty much omit that and it won't show when it's zero. If you want it to show, you can simply get rid of the extension or you can add a 1. And then 1 will show the extension. I hope you understood. I think you probably might have gotten the gist of it without me demonstrating. But yeah, on that note, I'm going to pretty much wrap the video here. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to smash that subscribe button. Thank you to those who are subscribed. It means a lot to the channel. Also follow my Instagram. Check out my website at kidscoding.com. Links are in the description below. And thank you all for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.